Well, you're on a ship when you notice some water foaming nearby. It looks as if a huge vessel has just sunk there, but you don't see any debris. Steam is rising over the water, and large bubbles appear on the surface. In a couple of minutes, you see a small piece of land appear right in front of your eyes. It's releasing flames and lava. Millions of gallons of water evaporate in the mouth of the volcano. Frightened, you get away from this place. For the next 3 years, the small island covered with volcanoes will be slowly emerging from the water. Every day, it'll erupt and fill the sky with black ash. When the ash settles, it'll get mixed with the water and form the shore. This eruption lasted 3 years, and finally, by 1967, the island of Surtsey on the southern coast of Iceland was fully formed. Surtsey is one of the few islands that have emerged from the depth to the surface of the sea. But it's almost impossible to get here. The island has a unique ecological system, and scientists want to find out how it's going to develop without human influence. Only a few people from all over the world have permission to walk around the island. This next place looks unwelcome from afar. We're now in Australia, in the Tasman Sea. Here, a huge ridge resembling a sharp fin of a giant shark sticks out of the water. The height of this mountain is 1,800 feet, which is almost twice the height of the Eiffel Tower. This place is called Ball's Pyramid. It's located in the center of an uninhabited volcanic island. It's difficult to get here because of the inaccessible rocky landscape of the place. The island was first discovered in 1788. At that time, I wasn't around then, it was considered barren and devoid of life. But more than 200 years later, in 2001, a group of scientists arrived at the island, and they found some incredible creatures there. They accidentally discovered the rarest insect in the world. It happened when the researchers reached the island, climbed to the height of more than 100 feet, and spotted a bush. Under it, they saw a colony of bugs known as land lobsters, or walking sausages. These creatures belong to the family of stick insects. Each of them is about 6 inches in length. This is the length of a spicy bratwurst. Mmm, add a little mustard and relish? Yum! Oops, back to bugs. That day, people found 27 insects. But since then, their population has begun to increase. These creatures were believed to have become extinct in the early 20th century. But to the contrary, they somehow managed to get to the Ball's Pyramid and survive. Our next stop is Brazil, almost 93 miles from the center of Sao Paulo. That's where you can find an island that's almost impossible to get to. But if you succeed, you're unlikely to leave it. It's called Snake Island. There's no other place on the planet with such a high concentration of snakes. According to researchers, there are about 5 snakes for 10 square feet of land there. They are the only owners of the island, since no other animals can survive among them. Snakes there are one of the most venomous species in the world, the golden lanceheads. These snakes are about 1.5 feet in length. Their venom is very powerful and fast-acting. If you let this reptile bite a raw piece of meat, the place around the bite will start to melt. Wow, count me out. Now, imagine you're on this island and the snakes don't bite you. The most interesting thing that you can find there is an old lighthouse. It's hidden in the dense foliage of trees. People lived on the island a long time ago. Rumor has it that the last keepers were in the lighthouse when snakes broke in. No one has lived there ever since. How these unique snakes appeared on the island is still a mystery. The most popular legend claims that a pirate came there a long time ago. He hid a treasure somewhere on the island. Then, he left the snakes in the spot where the chest was hidden. The pirate hoped the reptiles would scare people away from his gold coins and jewelry. Since then, a few snakes have managed to increase their population thousands of times, and some of them, reportedly, are wearing jewelry. Nah, not really. If you ever wanted to get to the island for some reason, the patrol services would stop you. Only a few people in special protective suits can get there to conduct scientific research. The next island is located 17 miles south of the center of Mexico City. You can easily get here. There are no poisonous animals, nobody guards the place, and the island's landscape allows you to moor a boat. But most likely, you'll want to leave this place as soon as you walk there for a while, especially if you arrive at night. Dolls are hooked on trees all over the island. These toys have different clothes, different sizes, and different faces. You can find dozens of dolls on almost every tree. In the middle of the 20th century, one of the residents of Mexico City moved to this island and began to fill it with toys. He picked the dolls up from landfills and canals all over the island. It took him several decades to decorate each tree. In the beginning, it looked strange and interesting. Thousands of tourists came here to see the island. Then, the dolls began to age and rot. Rains and hot sun deformed their faces. Covered with moss, they started to take terrible shapes. But the worst thing is that some people believe these dolls come to life at night. Imagine wandering alone on this island under the light of the moon and suddenly noticing a hanging doll without one eye.
Ew!
It's turning its head in your direction. A second later, you're already jumping into the boat and sailing away as fast as possible. One of the most unsafe and inaccessible places on Earth is located in the waters of the Bay of Bengal. This is North Sentinel Island. It's a small piece of land that looks like a tropical paradise. But you won't get here for two reasons. Since 1956, any trips to this island have been prohibited by law. There are always several ships going around and patrolling the area. The second reason is located on the island itself. Imagine you've managed to get past the patrol boats. You're sailing on a small boat to the shore. Crystal clear water surrounds you. You can even notice passing fish and beautiful coral reefs. Ahead, you see the golden coast and bright green trees. And among them, you notice small dots. You get closer, and an arrow whizzes by a few inches away from your face. The next arrow is stuck in the wooden hull of the boat. The dots you noticed before are people, the local Sentinelese tribe. They're standing with bows, releasing arrows, and throwing spears at you. They are screaming something and waving their hands. You understand they are not happy to see you and will do everything to prevent you from reaching the shore. The Sentinelese have long been isolated from the whole world and are now defending their island in such an assertive way. They don't seem to be afraid of anything. Once, a helicopter flew to the island, and the locals still threw their spears and shot arrows at it. It's forbidden to approach the place, not only because it's unsafe for tourists, but also to protect the local tribe from the dangers of civilizations. People from the continent can easily bring some disease to the island and infect its inhabitants. The locals don't have immunity, even from the flu or a simple cold, never mind smartphones. In addition, the island is surrounded by a coral reef, and this makes it very difficult for large ships to reach the shore. Despite all the prohibitions and the danger, many people have tried to get to the island. In 1880, an officer got to the shore and discovered that the soil there was ideal for growing coconut palms. The man also found several villages on the island, but didn't dare to meet with the locals. Eventually, he left this place, alive. Since then, many more attempts have been made to get to the island. Many times, researchers and travelers gave the islanders gifts, like fish or coconuts. The locals accepted these presents, asked for more, but still didn't allow foreigners to approach their homes. It's also difficult to make friends with the local tribe because they communicate in one of the most complex languages in the world. Scientists and linguists have been studying it for decades. And at the end of the 20th century, some researchers managed to make friends with the Sentinelese. In 1991, the islanders were invited to board a large ship. A team of anthropologists gave them bags with coconuts. Only several members of the tribe accepted the gifts. For centuries, the Sentinelese have been living on their own, far from civilization. And almost nobody wants to change this situation. What, and pass up the internet, fried food, and Facebook? You're kidding.